So, like, I noticed something, right? And they say communication is key. So, I'm communicating now. Ladies, let me ask you something. Do you guys ever, like, apologize for anything when you'll do something? Or maybe say you don't apologize. Like, do y'all ever do anything in general? I know some of you gonna get offended. I'm like, what? What are you talking about?
What? I mean, we do. I do. I love my person.
But what I've noticed is that a woman will never apologize when she's wrong. Even guys, I need you to think on this one. Guys especially, think on this one. The last time you and your girlfriend fought, who was the one who came to her and made peace? Even if she came to you after a fight and she was wrong and she was like, babe, you know what? I was wrong. And I feel like we should talk this out. And y'all start talking. She finds a way to make you the blame for everything. And then you sit there like, yeah, maybe I was wrong. I mean, I apologize. Yeah, baby, I'm sorry. Yeah, and then you apologize. She came to you to make peace, but you apologize in the end. Meaning that she did not apologize. And I've been watching rom-coms. Because, like, I mean, y'all, I've just been watching it. So, and I've noticed that during breakups, the woman wouldn't come make up. It's always the guy. The guy's always the one who would come make up. And now, I'm speaking now reality. Reality. If a guy has to break up with a girl, the girl's not gonna make the means to try and make peace with him. And I'm not saying every girl. There are some girls who will be like, hey, Justin, please come back to me. I will not let you have another vagina. It's my dick. The dick is mine, Justin. All right, there are women like it, right? But 99.99 and a half. So that half percent woman, that half percentage, those are the ones that would come make peace. The others, yeah, they don't make peace at all. They find reason on why they should hate you more. Let me say that again. They find reason on why they should hate you more. They Google stuff like, how to get rid of my ex. How to stop thinking about my ex-lover. They listen to music. Realize, bitch, get a fuck by that nigga. They go to their friends. And they know their friends are thoughts. And the friends say, hey, you know what? You should fuck his best friend. And then she's like, you know what, girl, he does not have best friends. If he did have best friends, I would have fucked his best friend. And the fucking thought friend will be like, you know what, does he have a dog? And then it's like, yeah, and the dog is Mari's best friend. Then you go to those type of friends. Or, you listen to Abuchine Icon. None of your concern anymore. I'm none of your concern. You listen to stuff that makes you hate the person more. Ladies, let us do this, man. Let's be level, man. Yazin. You work for me, I work for you. Why I must do all work? Why I must always be the one making peace? I cannot always be the peacekeeper. You know what I've noticed? When the relationship dies, it's not because the guy has given up. It's because the guy is waiting for the girl to at least come fight for him for once. A guy also wants to feel like, you know what? She fought for me. She loves me. I love you too, boo. I'ma love you forever. But he's waiting because, like, you know what? For the past 100 fights, I've been the one making peace. Let her make peace just once. Nigga, wait 60 years and there's no peace coming. Just more beef.
Ladies, you're a no-man.